When I made the move, when I decided to go with the JPT, I didn't realize what their game plan was going to be. And when they came in, the Atlas of Science was just being launched, more or less, as research reviews, okay? And Sandy Grimwade was the editor, and we were getting these reviews written. And if we had held out for 5 years, I think it would be a very useful and profitable set of review articles that would be issued based on the concepts that we developed of identifying the emerging fields of disciplines of science through co-citation analysis. Well, naturally, in the first year or two, I mean, it wasn't an instant success, nor was SCI. If they had been here when the SCI started, they would have killed it before it got off the ground. And they killed that product as they then killed the scientist. Of course, in the case of the scientist, they might have made a wise financial decision. But that was an entirely different kind of a story because of the difficulty we had that time when we had that FBI problem with the guy that planted the was it Microsoft software that they said?
WordPerfect.
Huh? WordPerfect?
Yep.
I didn't even know how to use this stuff. I probably paid the largest price for WordPerfect than anybody in the world just to get them off our backs. So, anyhow, the Atlas of Science, now you hear people talking about it like it's a natural thing to do. But especially when I saw the work they're doing down at Oak Ridge on it with this huge mapping thing. You ought to go down there to see that sometime. That control, command and control map, really unbelievable. It's, that thing is bigger than this wall. Huge. I don't suppose the average user is going to be able to afford that, even with HD TV. It's probably like, what, 30 foot HD TV screen.
Outside our budget.
But I guess people buy them. I guess they have them outside the tennis matches. They have these huge screens. I don't know if they're HD, but they have them.